In this video, we'll take a look at how to calculate the Pearson R correlation coefficient in Microsoft Excel. And in this video, we're going to use the function approach. So I'm going to go ahead and type correlation here. And then in this next cell, I'm going to use the function correlate. And I can find that actually. Let's go ahead and do that. If I go to FX here, the function, I can go to statistical. And then here I should see CORREL. There's correlate. Now notice here it says CORREL array 1, array 2. So let's go ahead and select OK. And then for array 1, I have my values here under hours studied. So I select those. Notice now it says B2 through B14, which is in fact these values right here. B column B, row 2, all the way through column B, row 14. Next, click in the array 2 box. And then select the values from C2 to C14. And notice they're displayed here. Then go ahead and click OK. And there's our value for a correlation. And you can see here the actual function is displayed in the formula bar, where we have equals CORREL, which indicates we're using the function correlate. And then this indicates the first set of values, as we saw, B2 through B14. And then the second set of values are here, C2 through C14. So this indicates that there's a strong positive correlation or relationship between hours studied and exam grade, suggesting that those who studied more hours on the exam tended to do better on that exam in terms of their grade, and those who studied fewer hours on the exam tended to do worse. And this is a pretty strong correlation, as the highest value we can have is 1.0. However, at this point, we don't know if the test is statistically significant or not, and that's what we'll take a look at in our next video. Thanks for watching.